Imagine you're going to Disney World and you're only going to be there for, say, a weekend or a day, and you want to get as much cool stuff in as possible. So you're like, I don't care, I'll be at the park 2 hours early, so I'm first person in line. I will be the last person to leave the park. They'll have to drag me out, whatever it takes. How do I fit in every single thing that I want to fit in? You're only there for 2 days. You don't want to be spending 2 hours in line waiting to get on Space Mountain. You want to spend 10 minutes in line on Space Mountain. How do you minimize the waiting time, the walking time? How do you make sure that all of your time is spent on the rides doing what you want to do? So to solve this problem, we look to a classic problem in mathematics called the traveling salesman problem, where you have a salesman who's trying to visit a bunch of cities, and he knows the distances between each pair of cities, and he wants to find out what's the shortest path. It's actually amazing how much math goes into something like Disney, because there's like millions of people, thousands of employees. You got to coordinate all of that stuff, and a lot of that is just math. Math teaches you how to think as much as any major can, and it really gives you a whole good set of skills on how to think something through logically and methodically. Math is all about asking questions about why are things true, or if I know some facts, what can I find out from them? It's all about problem solving. When you're working on a problem for that long, you just get frustrated. Like, it doesn't matter who you are. If you're working on a problem and you just can't get the answer, you just get really frustrated. And then you just keep trying and trying and trying. Maybe you put it away for a while, maybe you come back to it. And then finally, just that one moment where everything clicks, and it's just like a mixture of relief and just like pure joy. 2 days ago, Danny and I finally got our program working fully. We included what we felt were the top 30 attractions in Magic Kingdom. If you just took those top 30 attractions and you were trying to find a way to do it and just pick them out of a hat, it would take you multiple days to do, just because you'd be stuck in waiting lines so long. With our program's optimization, we got it down to about from 9 a.m. to 8 p.m. at night. So that's pretty significant improvement, and we're far from done, so we're really happy with our initial results. In a very real sense, the math we do here can and does help people in the real world.